Thank you very much, Rainer and Monica, for kind introduction, and thank you very much for organizing the school. And so my name is Dorota Pawlak, and I was told exactly by Rainer what I have to say and what I have not to say. So I will say a little bit about our center. So the long name of our center is Center of Excellence for Nanophotonics, Advanced Materials and Novel Crystal Growth Technologies. It is actually so long to stress that we combine three things, so nanophotonics, advanced materials and crystal growth. The short name is ensemble to the power of three, which you can see here, and even shorter is E3. So as it was already mentioned, our center was created within Teaming for Excellence program, but also through Polish funding coming from International Research Agenda program by Foundation for Polish Science and also some funds from Polish ministry. And we are created as a non-for-profit limited liability company. We are actually a research institution. This means that we can have profits, but we don't give it to our owners, so we can keep our profits for making research. So what is Teaming for Excellence? It's a program within Horizon, different kind of programs called Spreading Excellence and Widening Participation. And the aim of it is to create new centers of excellence in low research and innovation performing countries, of course, in partnership with outstanding research institutions. This is a slide where we are actually getting the project. So the project is represented here by Professor Jose Pitarque from Nanogune and myself. So what is our center about? It is about, first of all, about crystal growth. So as you can see, the crystal growth is in the center of our center. Why crystal growth is so important? You probably might not know, or you may know, that the most widely used method for crystal growth is Czochralski method. And Czochralski was a professor who was born in Poland, and half of his life worked in Germany and half in Poland. And with his method, the first germanium crystal was grown, with which the first transistor was created in Bell Laboratories. Now we can make this kind of huge silicon crystals with this method, and all these silicon crystals go into all kinds of chips on which you have billions of transistors and which are in all of your devices. So even if you don't know it, each of you probably has a piece of crystal with you now. So without crystals, there will be no modern life. And what we are doing, we are trying to, or we do apply crystal growth to novel material concepts, especially in nanophotonics, like nanoplasmonics, metamaterials, but also other concepts like topological insulator heterostructures. And we try to develop new advanced optical materials for different kinds of applications. So our motto is photonics crystallized. Who helps us to do it? So we have two national partners. It's the University of Warsaw, which is the best Polish university, and Łukasiewicz Institute of Microelectronics and Photonics. And we have three advanced partners, as you can see, our angels who help us to put the roof on our center. It's Karlsruhe Institute of Technology, Sapienza University of Rome, and Nanogune. And we are very international. So we have International Scientific Committee. And you can see, of course, Rainer is in the committee, and as well as the director of Nanogune, Professor Pitarque. But you can see also some other names you might know. And what we are doing. So we are growing crystals. So single crystals, like oxide crystals, which have all kinds of applications, like laser materials, nonlinear materials, substrate materials, and scintillating materials. And we grow also single crystals of 3-5 compound semiconductors like arsenides, phosphides, antimonides, also topological insulators, and also silicon carbide. In fact, in some of them, we are the only producer in the European Union. And our research is mainly on this kind of novel photonic materials. So with crystal growth, we structure matter on micron scale and nanoscale, and typically it is structured within a volume of material. So majority of these materials are not not just at the surface, but they are volumetric. But of course, we also can make some materials just on the surface. And we put hearts into our work literally. So this is a scanning electron microscope image of a material we have grown. And as you can see, we can grow even hearts. And what we are trying to work on recently, it's we try to make materials which show properties and also applications of metamaterials, plasmonic materials, hyperbolic materials, also for spintronics, like topological insulator heterostructures, and also materials with enhanced Faraday effect, and materials for different kinds of energy materials, like for conversion and storage. And how we are connected with SNOM? First of all, of course, because we have Rainer in our project and in our International Scientific Committee. And also we have one piece of NEASPEC SNOM. And we have two light sources. One is coherent chameleon from around 400 nanometers to 4 micrometers. It is monochromatic laser where you can choose different kinds of wavelengths. And we have a broadband light source from 5 to 16 micrometers. And we can measure in transmission and reflection modes. And of course, we want to measure all these materials which I was showing. So our aim is to use the SNOM as a characterization tool for our novel materials. And I will just show you two examples of such materials. So one is our material of glass with silver nanoparticles. It's made long time ago already. So you cannot see it well, but depending on the background on which this glass is laying, the color is changing. So it is like in Roman Lycurgus cup. In Roman Lycurgus cup, you have red and green. Here you have blue and yellow. So in fact, it is like the different background works like looking at the material in transmission or reflection mode. That's why you see the change of the color. Of course, this is a long time back, and now we have a lot of advancements on this, but we make all kinds of dielectric materials with different kinds of particles embedded in, like plasmonic particles, quantum dots, rare earth ions. And another example, so we work on crystalline two-phase materials, so-called eutectic materials, and here you can see our topological insulator heterostructure. So these are layers made of topological insulator, bismuth telluride, the green ones, and embedded in tellurium. And you can see the interface between these two phases, which is really atomically smooth with the quintuplet layers of the layered structure of topological insulator parallel to the interface, with this conductive surface state kept in this material. And the material shows polarized terahertz emission. So this is one of examples of materials we work on. And I would like also to mention that we still look for group leaders for our center. So if you are interested, please let us know. And also we look for senior researchers in SNOM. So if you are also interested and you know a little bit on SNOM, please let us know. And with this, I would like to thank you for your attention.